Hi, my name is Marcel Beugelsdijk. This video is about referencing other rows in Power Query. This is the case. We have input, text, blocks of text separated by lines with slashes. And the question is to have all people playing soccer with the codes and the name and the age. So we have to search for soccer and then get the other data from different rows in the same table. I will show you two ways of doing this. The first way is often referred to in documentation on internet and so on. That is by using an index column. And the second way of doing it is much faster. And I came up with this myself. So the output should look like this. So we have the codes and the names and ages of all people playing soccer. And the first query is how it's done typically. You have a source. Type text, remove blank rows, add an index column, filter on soccer. So we got all the rows with soccer. And then I add a code. And that code is from the index table. So that's a previous table where it contained all the rows with data. So I take the row from the index table and I use index minus 4. So there is where the code is found. Then I add a name and I have referenced the same table indexed. Index minus 3, so there we find the name, remove the label, and similarly for age, I take the indexed table, index minus 2, make that numeric, remove other columns, and there's the result, close and load. This is the query I just explained. This is the other approach. When I press refresh, data gets loaded. Second one is already done, and now the first is done. So we can see that the second solution is quicker. Actually, it's much faster. How it is done? Now we have the source table. Typed and remove blank rows, so that's still the same. And now I do a combine using table from columns. In the first column, I skip 4 rows. The second column, I skip 1 row. The third column, I skip 2 rows. And the last column, I skip 3 rows. So we have all the required data next to each other. For instance, on row 6, the first hit, soccer, the code for Eva, age 19. And now it's just a matter of filtering, removing columns, and transform them. And then it's done. So the trick is to get all the columns with the data you need next to each other. If we take a look at the bottom of this table, then we see that missing data is padded with nulls. So we still have all the data required. And this runs much faster than the previous method, as we already saw. This is a file with much more data. As you can see, it's over 800,000 rows. With the same query. The first query is not there, otherwise this video would get very boring. If I refresh, let me do it this way, refresh, you see data gets loaded by chunks of 7,000-8,000 rows at a time. And it's done already for this huge file. So you can see that this method of referencing other rows in the same table is much faster than using an index column.